five devised deeds.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Thank you, Mr. Toastmaster and fellow guests and Toastmaster members. My college professor, the psychologist, used to always say, future psychologists will make many excuses. That's something to tell a bunch of 18 and 19 year olds in the room that is already scared about being away from home and sitting in a classroom full of 100 people. You will come up with many excuses to why you haven't moved forward in the success of your life. There are many reasons why people come up with excuses. In fact, everyone has different reasons for making them. However, it really boils down to when we only make excuses for the following reasons: the fear of failure, the fear of embarrassment, the fear of change, the fear of success, the fear of responsibility, and the fear of making mistakes. Then there's that perceived lack of confidence and resources. Today is February 10th, 2017. Most have abandoned their New Year's resolutions. Did you know 42% will never succeed and fail on their resolutions? To eliminate excuses from our lives, we must first look at eliminating the fear. Allow me to share a few excuses from the top 10 this year. The ultimate one: losing weight and being healthy. That's that fear of lack of confidence and resources. There's too many people at the gym. My knees hurt. Oh, it's just too expensive to buy healthy. Then there's that life and self-improvement resolution. You know, you wake up in the morning, oh, my life is just going to be great this year. We're going to start off the way we need to. Well, kicks in that fear of change. We all want to live a great life, but remember what my professor said. You will come up with many excuses why you haven't moved forward in the success of your life. Then there's this classic one. Some of you can and may not relate. It's that excuse of, I want to spend more time with my family and close friends. Then you get to thinking, it's that one family member that you come up with the best excuse not to be around. You know, I have this close friend. I've known her for 31 years. She's about 80% negative all the time. You would say to yourself, why are you still friends? And I could stand here and come up with many excuses to why we still have our friendship. One day she asked me to come visit her in Florida. And you know, I need that mommy and wife break. I long for it. I contemplated for a long time about going. Then I thought to myself, am I going to risk my sanity and my mind to sit in a room with her for hours to listen to the negativity? Or am I going to come up with some type of excuse and why I can't go? Now, I have to find some honesty there. And I have to be honest with her one day. I still make an excuse to why I can't come visit her in Florida. But last week, I decided that I am going to tell her why. And at least just see what happens. Because you know, that was one of my resolutions, not make an excuse. So I pushed on. Jennifer, I can't see you. I really can't come down there because I think that, you know, once I drive for 6 hours to come see you, I sit at your house, you're going to complain about this and that. And, you know, I sit on the phone with you for hours and listen to you complain about this and that. She's attentively listening to me. It's just crickets on the other end of the phone. I'm getting quite nervous trying to figure out what's going to happen. And I said, are you there? And she said, yeah, I'm here. You know, you're like the third person who told me that. And I said, wow, I feel better. She says, okay, so I get it. I understand. You don't want to be negative. What we're going to do, we're going to go to Universal. We're going to have fun. We're going to drink. We're going to do everything. And I'm not going to complain that long. So when you come. Still, my little part of my heart is telling me, man, don't do it. But you know what? I'm going to push on and I'm going to go ahead and go. Most resolutions have accompanied plenty of excuses. Glad to know that plenty of excuses for why you're no longer achieving your goals. Excuses are really placed in its own category, a behavior that hurts our own performance. It's more of a distraction that prevents us from achieving our tasks, but it's deeper than that. It's that unconscious desire to protect ourselves. I'll leave you with this. Before you make an excuse, think. Is it worth it? Is it worth the pain and the agony that I went through in deciding to go visit my friend? I often go back to this poem that I learned. Excuses are the tools of the incompetent. Those who specialize in them sell them not to anything, but nothing at all. Thank you.